But first, the latest developments on Sydney's collar bomb extortion threat, including a bizarre twist. First, a reporter Lachlan Kennedy, who's at the scene. And Lachlan, there's been movement there tonight.
Good evening, Sandra. Yes, the young victim of yesterday's terrifying 10-hour ordeal has arrived home. Young Maddie Pulver, along with her mother and her father, were driven home at about 8:30 tonight in an unmarked police vehicle. It's understood Miss Pulver had been with police several hours prior, giving them a full run-through again of yesterday's terrifying ordeal, as I said. Her father, William Pulver, did front the media today and gave a statement in which he said he was very proud of his daughter, but he also wanted to get on with life, and I think the fact they're home tonight shows they are definitely ready to do that.
10 agonising hours are written all over the tortured faces of Madeline's parents.
We particularly want to thank all of the people last night that did an extraordinary job helping our beautiful daughter.
Bill Pulver's only daughter, the apparent victim of his multi-million dollar success. The HSC student should have been studying inside the Mossman mansion. Instead, she was attacked by a masked man who strapped what she was told was a remote-controlled bomb to her neck.
There was a letter attached to this device, or a note attached to this device that did make certain demands. We are treating this as an attempted extortion.
The letter is believed to have made reference to a character in the novel Tai-pan by Australian-born author James Clavell. As investigations began, bomb disposal experts worked tirelessly to free Madeline, held prisoner by the device inside her own home.
Maddie particularly wanted to thank those few officers who spent many long hours sitting with her, showing little regard for their own personal safety. In her immediate vicinity last night. They were an incredible comfort during a horrific ordeal.
At Madeline's private girls' school, trial exams are suspended and students offered counselling.
She also wanted to thank an extraordinary group of friends, family, neighbours who were kicked out of their homes last night, and a wonderful, wonderful group of friends from her school and teachers from her school who were just incredibly supportive. In particular, a few of her school friends were standing at the end of our street for about 7 or 8 hours, wishing her well.
The wealthy Mossman community left reeling, wondering how this horrifying ordeal, which reads like a Hollywood thriller, could have unfolded in this dress circle street. Jacqueline Maddock, 10 News.
Back to Lachlan Kennedy at Mossman. And Lachlan, as was mentioned there in that story, a strange twist has emerged.
Well, Sandra, nothing has been clear-cut about this incident from the start, but as was mentioned, we understand there are some obscure references into the extortion note that was attached to the device. There were some references to the book Tai-pan by James Clavell. Now, that, of course, did talk about some warring corporate sagas, so there is some suggestion there that it may refer to the father's business. And it's also understood that the letter was actually signed off under the name Dirk Struan, which is the protagonist in that novel. Also today, we learnt that on the note there was an email address, and in the electronic device we understand there was a USB found which did contain another copy of the extortion note.
Lachlan Kennedy, thank you.